It's like I'm in Groundhog Day, just reliving the same week. Wham! Look at that! Bam! Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Today we're talking again about Xbox with another game going to PlayStation. You see, last week it was Forza Horizon 5, then it wasn't Forza Horizon 5 after Shinobi decided to delete the post from Reset Era, and then now apparently it's gonna be Indiana Jones. Oh, God. You know, I really don't know what's happening in the gaming cycle now. No one is talking about PlayStation. No one is talking about Nintendo, but everybody is talking about Xbox. And you know what's really funny about all of this? It's so interesting to me how the company that is in third place, apparently, is the one that everybody is pretty much always talking about. Every time I say the Xbox tax isn't real, this happens. But all kidding aside, no, apparently this is going to be a more substantiated rumor compared to the last rumor that we saw. And today may be the day that we actually see what's actually going to happen. Because the other piece of the puzzle is that this is going to be announced today at Gamescom later on after this video goes live. So we'll finally be able to get to see what the hell is even going on, what's actually happening, and what Xbox's plan is. And I have a couple of ideas myself. But before we get into that, let's take a look at the article from Insider Gaming and then go from there. A reputable insider has claimed that Indiana Jones and the Great Circle will be coming to PlayStation 5 after an expired time-exclusive window. This is according to Nate the Hate, who took the news to Twitter today, I'm not calling it X, I don't care, where he said Machine Games, Indiana Jones, and the Great Circle will release on Xbox and PC this holiday, December, as a timed console exclusive. After this timed exclusive window expires, Indiana Jones and the Great Circle is planned to come to PlayStation 5 in the first half of 2025. Now, this is super interesting to me because there's so many factors of what's been going on with not only the FTC case of Xbox, the purchase of Bethesda and ABK, and even what's happening now with the entire rumor of the whole Project Latitude thing happening for Xbox. So why am I bringing up the FTC? Well, let's go back about a year here. It turns out that Steven Dottillo found this out during the actual trial of what's going on with the FTC and Xbox when buying ABK, and they were questioning Pete Hines, and this is what happened. FTC lawyer questioning Bethesda's Pete Hines confirms that Disney had a deal for an Indiana Jones game that'd be for multiple consoles. Hines confirms the FTC says the deal was amended post-acquisition to be Xbox only for consoles. And this is where things sort of like start getting a bit muddy. Was there a new deal struck with Disney after the ABK deal? Is Microsoft doing these sorts of things in order to sort of appease the FTC and get them off their back to maybe even acquire more publishers or developers in the future? There are a lot of things going on that we don't even really know about or backroom dealings that are actually happening. But honestly, I think a couple of things may in fact be happening. And one thing that I would like to actually have happen is for Microsoft to just come out and say it. Just say it. Just say your Xbox is timed and that is it. And then go from there. And that is how it's going to be. Or just put everything everywhere. Because I have an idea of what they can do. But we'll get to that in a moment, like I said. The thing is, though, we're not going back to Nate the Hate. And he was the one that originated the actual rumor of Starfield going to the PS5 and so many other games going to PS5. Where it got so bad that he then had to go ahead and make a retraction and then have Xbox and Phil Spencer be like, it's just four games, it's only gonna be four games. When we all know, when everybody thought the same thing for PlayStation games going to PC, like, oh, it's only a couple of games 2 years apart, then 1 year, then 6 months, then 3 months. Now you get trophies on PC. Now you get day and date. Like, it's going to be that way regardless because companies want to make as much money as they possibly can. And I don't understand why people don't even have this thought process. The console wars are over. And not because PlayStation 1 or Nintendo 1. The console wars are over because, again, companies need to make more money than they possibly can actually imagine. And they're going to do that by selling more games to more platforms. If you don't believe me, again, Horizon, the Lego Horizon game, is on the Nintendo Switch, or coming to the Switch. If that doesn't tell you who's a third-party company, then I don't know what is. And I don't want to hear the excuse of, well, Lego mandated it. Ah, yes, Lego. Yeah, they're the ones with the balls around the room here, right? Telling PlayStation what to do with their own IPs? Yeah. You guys, I swear, every time, fanboys, I swear. But you see, these kinds of things are going to be happening more and more until Microsoft simply just rips the Band-Aid off. And honestly, they should. Everybody should play every game on every platform. And people got really mad at me when I made that tweet. Actually, the people that got mad at me were Nintendo fanboys and PlayStation fanboys. Who could have imagined, huh? Because that's the thing. As someone who primarily plays on PC and is going through a really insane midlife crisis of buying old PS1 and PS2 games, there really is no need to have a console or have a specific dedicated box when all of these consoles are in fact just form factor broken down PCs with an APU, a CPU, and a GPU. Everybody's talking about the PS5 Pro, and all they're talking about are the actual specs, which really is kind of funny when you think about it, because these consoles aren't like the PS3 or the 360 anymore. There's no dedicated hardware. They're all made by AMD. So they're all basically PCs anyways. And the fact that they're all backwards compatible to a degree and can play older games and could do things like going online, streaming on Twitch or YouTube, you're basically playing on a PC for $500. You might as well just get all the benefits of PC gaming. But there's more in the article. Let's continue. According to insider gaming sources, some outlets have been given the heads up on the news and have signed NDAs, but it's currently unclear on if the information will be announced on Tuesday opening night live or not. Nate claims come from following another report from The Verge's Tom Warren on February, which we all know how Tom Warren likes to get down, don't we? Who stated that Bethesda was considering bringing Indiana Jones to PlayStation 5. So you know what? Let's get to my take on this whole thing about this, right? Because the real problem with Xbox isn't they don't have any games or Game Pass bad. The real problem with Xbox has always been their messaging. They can't message anything. And they let rumors and things like this just fly off the handle and everybody starts speculating. People start tweeting. Then you start going crazy. Then fanboys start losing their minds and you got some flip-flopping. Some are saying they love PlayStation now. Others are saying, oh, we hate Xbox. Some are saying they're going to buy a PC. If you're going to buy one, buy Starforge. Link in the description down below. Help out your boy. Support him. You know what I'm saying? But the reality is this, like I've said before, companies need to make as much money as they possibly can, and they're going to do anything they can to make that money. That's why Final Fantasy 16 is being released for PC next month. That's why God of War Ragnarok is coming to PC. That's why companies like PlayStation are in fact catering to PC gamers, even though they're doing it in a really horrible way by locking their games via region lock because they want to use their sort of like garbage login for MAUs because they want to increase that. Way to go, guys! But again, every company is in fact third party, whether fanboys want to admit it or not. People sitting here and bragging like, haha, we got your games now, are really just the most moronic batch because those exact same people are in fact losing their games to the PC at the same exact time. And this really goes to show that this entire conversation is nothing more than just fanboys being fanboys and people trying to sit here and act like they're mightier than thou about the right box that they purchased because, oh, I get to wait 6 months after you got the game so I could play the game now. Okay, great. So who cares, bro? It's a video game. And here's the real rub about what's actually going to be going on and where I think Xbox should really start pushing more into what the messaging should be rather than just leaving things out into the air. Even if Xbox says, hey, we're putting our games day and date on the PlayStation, they can still come out ahead on this because one, they're getting more money from PlayStation players who don't want to have an Xbox. And two, they can really push the value of Game Pass and say, hey, look, why pay 70 when you can pay 20 and get everything else like Call of Duty, like everything else that we have in our library that we've now paid and bought for. I also think at the same time too, Xbox has to quote unquote play nice because of the FTC and how things have been going and how under scrutiny they have been, even still to this day, a year after the whole thing actually closed. Now, what can Xbox actually do to really pull ahead of the market? They can just make a PC. That's it. That's literally it. If they make a handheld that is totally open, that simply has Windows as an OS, and they fix the Windows OS to work properly in a tablet form, just release the PC. And then you get every game. Imagine going to somebody and saying, why buy a PS5 or a PS6? If you've got an Xbox, whether it's the new console or the handheld, you can get every game. Your Steam library's on there, your Epic Game Store library's on there, and every Xbox Game Pass game is on there. Plus, you can take it on the go if you want the attachment or peripheral to it as well. I think that is a bigger selling point that people truly don't understand of what it actually could be. Think of it like in this perspective. The Steam Deck can no longer play PlayStation games. It can't. And the reason why it can't is because Proton and Linux are not compatible with PlayStation's own proprietary login service for PSN. You can't get trophies, you can't log in, your game effectively is bricked and broken because of the fact that you can't play the game on Linux. So there's no way for you to play PlayStation games on your Steam Deck handheld anymore, but you can do it on Windows. And that's going to be the ticket. And I know people are going to be saying things like, well, they'll just block it. Well, you can't just block games from going onto PC now, can you? Because they're not blocking that now, are they? Ta-da! And just to double back on that point, PlayStation isn't blocking games from being released on the Asus ROG Ally, even though that is a Windows handheld PC, or the other types of handheld gaming devices like the GDP Win and etc. If Microsoft just says we're releasing a handheld PC that has controller support on the side, well, I guess that's going to be a problem now, is it? And that's the one way I think that Xbox could actually pull ahead and win this, even if they are going through and putting their games onto competitor platforms. Again, they just want to make as much money as they possibly can, whether it's through Game Pass MAUs or people just buying the game outright. And I think they're playing a game far ahead of what anybody can actually see. The problem is that they're not actually acting on it, or they're not telling you exactly what it's going to be. They're leaving everyone in the dark, and truly, that is Microsoft's biggest Achilles heel. It always has been their biggest Achilles heel. They can't message anything properly. That's why everybody calls Phil the silver-tongued liar, because every time he says something, there's always a little bit of doublespeak in there, and you can't figure out whether he's being honest or if there's going to be some sort of like little caveat, like, oh, I didn't say this word, I said that word, therefore I didn't lie. Like, it's one of those kinds of things, because they always have things changing and shifting. And I think, again, like I said before in last week's video, Satya Nadella is the one running the ship. It's not Phil anymore. And there's a big fight happening internally. And that's what I think is going on with all of this. That's why, as we pointed back to that tweet earlier from Steven Totillo, we saw that, hey, Indiana Jones is Xbox exclusive, but now we're getting the rumors that it's not and it's coming to PS5 within 6 months. So what's really going on back there? So again, let's be real about this, right? The entire concept of like, oh, I have exclusivity or I have your games, that's out the window. Everybody's going to be getting everyone else's games, whether they like it or not. The console wars are over, not because a specific console brand won, but because the market has in fact seen the very top of whatever it could do back in the actual 2020s, and they're never going to get there again unless they make drastic changes. And I think that's what everyone is striving to do. It's why you see PlayStation putting games on PC. It's why you see Xbox putting games on PS5. It's why Nintendo is just went to the handheld route, because that's what they've always been good at. And they're not truly seen as a console competitor, even though they actually are. And if you want to be honest, they're the ones who really did win the console war in the end. Imagine that. Nintendo were the ones who saved the console business, and then they're the ones who actually won it. Kind of wild, huh? So with all of that being said, let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section down below. Is this something that's going to be impacting you negatively? Are you angry about this? Do you think it's actually going to be Indiana Jones or Forza Horizon 5? Like I said, I want to see what you guys have to say, so we'll check it out there. If you like this kind of content, you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. Now, we've just broken 73,000 subscribers. I just want to say thank you guys so very much. It really does truly mean a lot. Now, if you guys want to see more of this kind of content, more PC port reviews, we have a lot coming out this week. We've got Concord, we've got Assassin's Creed, we've got a bunch of other ones happening this week and next week, so PC port reviews are going to be pretty hot and heavy. This entire week, so be ready for that, so get ready. There's going to be more gaming news like this, more fanboy content. I'm still working on Steam Deck stuff. There's just been a lot of bugs recently, a lot of updates, and I might have to make updates for older videos as well. Stuff for like Fallout and doing Fallout London on your Steam Deck. That might be a fun one to do, so stay tuned for that as well. So if you want to see all that kind of content, plus live streams every Saturday night, 8:45 p.m. Eastern, subscribe. Trust me, you'll have a great time. And if you want to have emotes during those live streams or Discord access, become a YouTube member. It's as low as a dollar. If you don't want to spend the buck, don't sweat it. Just come on down to this live streams again, like I said, at 8:45 p.m. Eastern, Saturday nights. You'll have a great time as chat just insults me, berates me, makes me do really dumb things using TTS, and it's an entire nightmare for about 5.5 hours. And then we raid VTubers at the end. It's a lot of fun, believe it. But with all that being said, thank you so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.